Hey everybody, how's it going? This is Dr. Bad Vibes. I'm here to do a quick tutorial on the modding of Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. So you've probably seen some of the videos in the past, and some a little more recent, put a new one up showcasing some of these characters. And I'm just going to do a quick rundown on how you would install these. And before I totally start this tutorial, I do want to preface this by saying I had no hand in making these mods. I have nothing to do with it. I get a lot of comments in my compilation videos asking me to do things or thanking me for doing, you know, whatever to what character. I did nothing. All I did was install this and show it off. So show some love to the team. I'm going to put, you know, credits in the description. You can see the full credits in the mod pack as well and on the link that I'll put in the description. But yeah, I have nothing to do with it. I haven't modded a game since like Quake 2, so all my knowledge is archaic and useless in this. But I do know how to install it, so that's what we'll do. So first things first, this only works on the PC version. People ask that a lot, like, will it work on my PS4 or PS3, whatever. Even if it's modded, there's no way to do it right now. There may never be, I don't know. But currently, the PC version through Steam is what you want. I will post some links up. Usually this game is on sale. If you don't have it, be sure to wishlist it because it goes on sale for like $7 very frequently. It may be right now, so I'll update that in the comment and description where it's at, you know, about how much it is. Once you have the game or if you already have it, make sure it's installed. Get it installed. And from there, open Steam, go to your sidebar, and right-click the game and go to Manage. And you're going to go to Browse Local Files. This is going to open up the actual directory it's in. And these are the game files here. This is where all your Steam games live. So what I did, I made a new folder and I just duplicated the files that are in the actual game folder. And again, this is totally optional. This is just so I keep a backup. And sometimes I do like to play the untouched, unmodded version. So that keeps it there. I can get updates. If it ever gets an update, I'll see it. It's probably not going to at this point, but you know, this came out in like 2011, I believe. So this new folder is what I used to install. So it's going to be a little different. This has all the modded files in it already. You can kind of see references to it here. And what I did, made the new one, and you click add a game, add a non-Steam game, and then you browse to that folder where all the Steam games are. You pick that, pick the executable, and that will add it to your sidebar. And you can kind of do whatever you want with that. You don't have to worry about it being updated or messed with. Like, if you do extra modding to it and break the game, it's not going to mess it up and you still have the original one in Steam. But that's up to you. Me personally, I do this with Marvel 3. I don't do it with the Marvel Infinite. I have the Beyond mod because honestly, I'm not going to play the base game. I just want the mod at this point, and they're pretty good about responding to updates right now. But anyways, once you're here, this is where you launch the game. I haven't done anything. You can set a custom background, logo, all that. Pretty much the whole point is to preserve the original game. Anyways, I'll proceed. I'll let you make that decision. That's your own call. It's not that big of a game by today's standards. It's only 3.5 gigs if you have to download it. But I'd rather not have to do that. I like to have the backup on my disk. And this one's untouched. This is the, you know, the stock game. Don't have to worry about it. And then I can launch the modded one when I want to play. Anyways, I'm going to move forward. You decide that on your own. I'll show you how to actually mod it. With that out of the way, let's get to the actual modding part. So you're going to go to the local files, and so this is the copy of my base game. I'm just using this for an example because I haven't installed anything yet. And you're going to want to download the actual mod files. So I'm going to have these linked in the description. This is on Nexus Mods. This is probably the biggest difference from the last video I made. Everything used to be hosted on Game Banana. And those are still up. There's a lot of stuff up still. Most of this is old. It does look like it occasionally gets updates. But Nexus Mods, this is where everything is now. Constantly getting new content, usually skins, music packs, things like that. But let's focus on this one. This is the actual big mod pack that makes it super easy. This is made by Havengers. Give him a shout out. I will link his channel in the description as well. I believe they still do, I think they still do weekly tournaments based on this, but this is the all-in-one ready to go mod set. If you've modded Infinite and Beyond, this is very similar. So you'll navigate here, download it. There are some optional files. So the main one is the first one. There are some optional files, like if you're just updating it, which was the case for me, but we're going to do it like it's brand new. They do have a tournament build, so this changes some of the UI and the backgrounds, some of the music. And even more so, there's tons of costumes for Jury. So if she happens to be your favorite character, or hey, you just really like feet, they've got you covered. Plenty of costumes. And probably one of the other important things, they do have all the move lists in PDF form. So that's very, very handy. It's very well organized. It looks like the, I think what was in the manual in the actual game, but it's all there. Makes it very easy. So you know how to do everything with everybody. Okay. Once you have that downloaded and extracted, here on the right, this is the extracted community build. These are all the files. On the left, in my case, I'm using the standard Marvel 3 directory just as an example because I've already got this installed. So once it's extracted, then you're going to select all of the files, drag them over to the directory, and they'll all copy. It'll ask if you want to overwrite some of the files. Tell it yes. Those are the mod files copying over the actual game files. And then everything should look like this when you're done. It's, you know, it has more things controlling the mods. And one of the biggest additions included in this mod is the clone engine mod by Genesis 64. You can select the characters now. This has been a thing for a while, but it's still amazing that this was able to happen. Rather than having to use all the alt color slots to hold these characters, there's like an extra set of character boxes that you can't see. They're invisible underneath the main ones, but they work just the same. You may want to make note where the, you know, your favorite characters are because you can't see them. But believe me, this is much better than having to write down what, you know, what character's alt color is the mod that you want. This is a huge collaborative effort with the community. Lots of people made tons of characters in some cases, and a few were reworked. Lots of work went into this. It all went together. So definitely tell everybody thanks and show them some love, because this is keeping this game alive, and it's made it an amazing new game. Again, once everything's copied, it'll look like this. And I would recommend, I've had this issue personally, go in your taskbar and completely close Steam. Every time I've done this and I haven't restarted Steam, it's almost like it caches the old version of the game or something, and the mods don't work or they don't work right. So definitely completely close Steam and reopen it. Don't just, if you just hit it like here and close window, that's not going to do it. You need to actually go in your taskbar and close Steam. And then once you reopen it, everything should work. It should boot up. Everything's fine. And you should be good to go. The only things I want to add is if you are using Linux or Steam Deck. So in Steam, you can do some launch options. You do need to override a few things. I've run into this. I've gotten it working on Steam Deck, but you do have to put these commands in or else the game, I think it just crashes. And this is all on the mod webpage, so you know, be sure to do this. I would probably put it in for any mods that you do on this game. It varies a little bit. Just if you're using the Steam Deck or another Linux system, this probably looks familiar. You've probably had to deal with something like this before. So just take note of this. Make sure you put this in your launch options for the game to work. But if you're using Steam Deck or Linux, I mean, the installation process is identical. You open Steam. If you're on Steam Deck, do it in desktop mode and right-click, show local files. You can get right to it, no problem. Same thing. This is just an extra step to make sure it works. And so this should have it working. This is the big community edition. This is a huge collaborative combination of all these mods. A lot of mods do exist on their own and are released on their own. A lot are like skins or sound packs. What I would like to mention from before, this was in my old video, the old tutorial, Game Banana is where most of the mods were hosted. So things that weren't ever updated or just made, you know, one and done, they still exist on Game Banana. So if it's something you don't see on Nexus mods, definitely check out Game Banana. I guess the most notable would be the Malamander mods. Bison's been reworked, so I wouldn't worry about him. But Urien, he is currently not in the community mod, so if you really want to mess with him, you'll have to install him separately. I don't know if he plays nice with that mod pack or not, so that's a good reason why you should have things updated, because sometimes multiple mods on top of each other, things might break. But usually things like skin packs, sound packs, those don't really break anything. I can't make any promises, but again, that's why we back things up. Keep all this backed up until you have the game the way you want it. You know, something personally I like, I want Taskmaster looked like Skeletor. He kind of had a palette like that in Vanilla Marvel 3, and then they took it out. But you have things like that, or even, you know, hey, here's Piss Frank West, because why not? If you want, you know, Frank West to look like he's soaked in pee, somebody's got you covered here. So there's that. But there are a lot of other options. You know, take a look at it. You can add these the same way as the main mod pack. There's usually instructions when you download them. Worst case, if you're doing something old, look at my old video. Lays all that out. But the main thing you're going to mess with when you mod these is this native PC x64 folder. And generally, these have instructions on where they go. And I would say 90% of the time, it's just this folder. It's already got the, you know, the internal directory structure set out. You just drag it on top of here, boom. It should be okay unless there's any kind of conflict. Any final notes on this I'm trying to think of? Most of this, like the community mod, I believe everything works in arcade mode. Sometimes when you install the individual ones, they may break arcade mode. So your mileage may vary on that. And that's probably it. And that's a big reason why this community mod is a good first step, because it all works. You don't have to worry about it breaking. Simple, you know, drag and drop, everything should work. If there's anything anybody wants to add, please leave it in the comments. Any questions, put it in the comments. I'll try to get back to it if I have an answer. Maybe somebody smarter has an answer. And if you've made it this far towards the end of the video, I want to say thanks. It really helps. You know, if you hear my voice now, I am an actual person behind this channel. I don't show up on this one much, but I do stream live every so often. I like to stream retro fighting games, so you can find me on Twitch, and I simul stream here to YouTube. All my VODs live here on YouTube. They're pretty easy to find. You probably know the drill on how to do that. In case you don't, you know, go to the main page. They're here under the live tab. I usually don't push these out to subscribers because I like to keep the live content and the compilation content separate. I don't really have a set schedule, but if you ever see me online, jump on, say hi, you know, say hey in the comments even. It's cool to have people play some of these old games with together, or when Marvel Infinite and Beyond came out, that mod, we installed it live on stream. A viewer actually installed it alongside us, got everything working, and then we had some matches right there, you know, day one. So that was pretty fun. We like to do stuff like that. So that's Twitch and YouTube, whatever your platform of choice is. Hey, follow on both. I appreciate it. And again, any questions or comments, please let me know. I hope this was informative and hopefully everything works. And thanks again to all the creators and the modders that made this magic happen. It is completely beyond me, but I did manage to install it. So hey, we got that going. So now let's all hop on and play some Marvel 3.
Perfect! Hyper combo KO!